campus of HH Dow High School for this evening's Saginaw Valley match. I am Jake Rietma alongside Northwood's own Sydney Groelick, a member of the volleyball team. We are privileged to have the perspective of a collegiate volleyball player on hand today. Sydney, thanks so much for being here.
Yeah, no problem, Jake. I'm really looking forward to tonight.
We have an exciting match ahead for you this evening featuring crosstown rivals, the Dow High Chargers, playing host to the Midland High Chemics. The Chargers come in with an impressive 23-7 record alongside a 6-1 conference record. They are coached by Mr. Jeff Dietrich, and even more impressive, the Chemics come in with a record of 24-17, but an undefeated record in Saginaw Valley play at 7-0. And folks, that is what is on the line tonight, a conference championship. If Midland High wins, they solidify their spot as the Saginaw Valley champions outright. If Dow is able to hand Midland their first loss in conference play, the two share a title for the 2016 Saginaw Valley League. And Sydney, talk about how crucial it is playing your rivalry and how intense it can be.
Yeah, tonight's an exciting game, let alone playing your rival, especially in the conference championship. You can already feel the energy in here. The student sections are filling up. I know exactly how it feels to be one of those girls out there. You're more excited than ever to be playing your rival with all your friends and family out to watch. Tonight's definitely going to be a really good game.
And in a game of this magnitude, there's so many times where win-loss records can be thrown out the window. But what are some keys to the game for both of these teams to stick to if they want to be victorious tonight?
I think the most important thing about tonight will definitely be limiting their errors, making sure they get their serves in, talking lots on the court so communication isn't an issue. Another big thing will be serve-receive. Usually the team that serves the best and passes the best is the team that wins, so that will definitely be the most important aspect of the game tonight.
So crucial to stick to your fundamentals in a game of this magnitude. Of course, the crosstown rivalry, the Midland Chemics pride up against the HH Dow High Chargers. And if you're just joining us, I am Jake Rietma alongside Sydney Groelick, a member of the Northwood University volleyball team. We'll have more on that later, but Sydney, thanks again for being here tonight. As we get set to watch these two teams take on one another, we are moments away from our player introductions and our national anthem. Again, it's the Dow High Chargers coming in with a record of 6-1 in the Saginaw Valley Conference and 23-7 overall, hosting the Midland High Chemics, who come in with an undefeated record in conference play at 7-0 and an overall record of 24-17. Before we send it down to for our national anthem, a couple of players to look out for Midland High, the tandem of Grace Reckaway up front alongside Ellie Jensen. And for the Dow High Chargers, it's Nadia Atten, who also leads the team in kills. We'll have more on that following the national anthem, but at this time, we send it down for our national anthem.
Thank you.
packed house here inside the Dow High Gymnasium for this evening's contest. Again, I'm Jake Rietma alongside Sydney Groylick. Before the national anthem, we touch briefly on a couple of key players for both teams. Up front for Midland High, it's the tandem of Ellie Jensen and Grace Reckaway, who have been tough to stop all season long and been dominant players for Coach Zurl's Midland High Chemics. I'm sure they will be crucial to the success of the Chemics this evening. And on the other side, it's Nadia Atten, who leads the Dow High Chargers in kills. And all season long, both Allison Burrell, Anna Blasey, Cheris Query, and Haley Tanis have done a nice job of setting her up to be successful. Before we get into today's match, Sydney, for those tuning in for maybe their first volleyball match, what are some basics to be looking out for?
Well, tonight's game is going to be best 3-5, and I know in the past these two rivals have taken it to five sets a few times, so I think we're all looking forward to seeing a really exciting game, maybe take it to five sets. Of course, the last one goes to 15 instead of 25 as the other four will. And I'm really looking forward tonight's game to seeing some good attacking from the girls you just mentioned, and some good defense too. It'll to make it a really exciting game.
That's right. The dynamics of the volleyball game can be so specific upon which individual game you're in. You know, one thing can change from game to the next. At your level, at the collegiate level, how often do you guys change the game plan in between games, or do you usually try to stick to what the game plan was heading in?
Yeah, we usually scout beforehand and try to plan our defense around their offense, but a lot of the time throughout the game, things change. A team might start tipping more often or sending balls deep, so you definitely have to look at what their offense is doing against you and change your defense to pick up their balls in order to score points on the offensive side.
Yeah, definitely some chess match that takes place within the game, a game within the game. But with that said, it appears both teams have said their final dues, and we are moments away from getting started here inside the Dow High Gymnasium. A great student section for both teams overflowing into the main section there. As you take a look to the left of your screen, Dow High, the home team, with their student section flooding into the middle section of the gymnasium. And Midland High, of course, just being across town, also brought the house as well, as they are in the white there on the right side of your screen. And we are underway as Reckaway gets it started for the Chemics, but serves it too long, and Dow goes ahead 1-0. Perhaps the pregame jitters can be constant for both teams, as Dow sends one long, and both teams open up with service errors. Sydney, something you touched on.
I'm sure they just have to shake some nerves off.
1-1, and the ball goes back to Midland High. Atten at the net. Dug out nicely by the Chemics, and now Reckaway with a chance to kill. And the point goes to Midland High. That backline kill by Reckaway, that's something the Chemics will look to utilize throughout the course of the match.
Again, a few nerves from Dow, but I think once they shake it off, see, she just made a great pass there.
Midland looking to respond. Atten at the net again, dug out nicely by Reckaway. And a block at the line by the Chargers. Great defense there by Dow. That's something both of these coaches have touched on, the importance of playing defensively. You saw it in action there for the Chargers. Blasey to serve for Dow High. 2-2 game. And Midland comes away with the point.
A great pass from Julia Gross there. That's what starts it really, is a good pass on the from the serve.
Gross has been a crucial member to the Chemics' success all season long. Jensen at the net, sends it way too far, and Dow picks up the point. We'll see if Jensen is able to settle down, because she clearly is capable of dominating a game. She just appears to be a little overexcited at the moment. A nice placement that time by Midland High, and sending it into the back corner for the Chemics was Peyton Gerstacker. Great placement on that set. Jensen to serve for the Chemics. Quick shot by Skinner, doesn't catch the Chemics off guard. A nice response, and Reckaway sends it down with authority. A great kill by Reckaway to put the Chemics on top 5-3 here early.
Yeah, so far she's being really aggressive, which is nice to see.
Jensen serves again, and there's an ace. Great placement by Ellie Jensen. Caught the Chargers napping a little bit, as she's normally more forceful with the serve, but that one was placed perfectly. And there's another one. Back-to-back aces by Jensen for the Chemics, and they are on top big early, 7-3.
Dow switches up their serve receive to a two-man serve receive.
That's the great insight we're looking for. Two-man serve receive. I like that volleyball term.
Great tool off the block there by McMath.
Yeah, McMath gets it done for her first kill of the game. And this one's tinkering on the verge of Midland having complete control here early on top, 8-3. Dow will certainly take that. A chance for the Chargers to respond now. Substitution being made for Dow. Checking in to replace Jillian Skinner will be Shayna Draves for the Chargers. Query to serve for Dow. A tip by Reckaway is dug out nicely. Jensen with the backline spike. Dow chases it down, and Atten will return.
Great middle attack from Peyton Gerstacker there, right to the back corner. That's where the ball should be placed most of the time.
Yeah, Gerstacker has had two kills this game, and both of them have been placed perfectly, unable to defend that. Dow High both times, as Gerstacker's been effective early.
Back row attack from Atten.
Too far. 10-4 Midland High. Dow may need to regroup here, as Midland is executing much more effectively than the Chargers. But another chance, as Dow is the benefit of the long serve. In for the Chargers, Jenna Livingston. And Sol will serve for Dow. Another well-placed ball by Reckaway, and the Chemics on top, 11-5. Midland seems to be executing in the corners, whereas Dow is unable to place their shots well.
Livingston goes for a shot down the line, but just misses.
Yeah, that's a shot Midland High has been hitting, and Dow, unfortunately for them, have not been able to yet. 12-5 in the first game. Shot is sent long again, and Midland on the verge of taking complete control, and Dow High will go ahead and take timeout as Coach Dietrich will try to regroup the Chargers. Now, 13-5, obviously not the start you want if you're the Dow Chargers. Sydney, if you're in that huddle, what is the game plan to regroup if you're Dow?
Well, one thing for Dow, they've definitely too many errors, which I talked about earlier. They're hitting out a lot, a little bit of miscommunication in the back row. They have the right mindset, but I think they just need to focus in on keeping the ball in the court and not giving away points.
Yeah, Midland appears to be the more confident team in the early going. And if you're on the other side of things, if you're in the Midland huddle, you got to be saying just continue to execute the way we have been and continue to ride out the game plan. And this first game especially should be all ours.
Exactly. Midland's been playing a great game so far.
The service air gives the point to Dow as McMath was just a little too forceful on that serve and it sails long. 13-6 now. Vasquez serves for Dow, but Midland comes right back with the point of their own. And that's the Chemics, that's the reason right there why the Chemics are undefeated in Saginaw Valley play. So tough to beat, so versatile, a very deep team that can beat you in a multitude of ways.
Great set from Wolf.
Recaway to serve for the Chemics. Dug out by Velasquez. Midland with a chance. There's the kill from Jensen, placed perfectly. Another point for Midland High. If you're Dow, this has got to be tough. You have one of Midland's best players, Grace Reckaway, serving, and you have Jensen up at the front. Like we said, a lot of ways for the Chemics to beat you. There's the soft serve, but Dow responds nicely.
Great swing from Sheridan there, just off the tape of the net and out. Off the block first, though, so is a point for Midland.
Now Sheridan has done a nice job contributing to the Chemics' offensive effort throughout the course of this first game as well. The other end, it's Atten getting a point for the Chargers, a much needed point at that, as the score stands at 16-7, as Skinner will check back in for the Chargers.
That was a really smart play from Atten. She tooled it right off the block. It wasn't a great set, but she did use it and scored a point for Dow, so that's what you need to do in those tough situations.
Haley Tanis also checks in for the Chargers. Well, Jensen comes right back with a kill to put Midland on top by 10, 17-7. And if you missed the pregame with us, the games are played to 25. It's a best 3 out of 5. But that fifth game would be played to 15 if necessary. Oh, a tough break for the Chargers in Atten as she couldn't quite get the ball over the net on that misdirection play. And Midland will take over 18-7 now.
Again with that, again with the smart tip there through the block. It wasn't a great set. She was a little late, but she did get it over and in, and that's all that matters to get that point.
That's right. The effect, the bottom line is they got the point, and that's what makes it an effective shot. And now Dow starting to build some momentum with a couple of points of their own. Still trail 18-9, but Blazing looking strong at the service line for the Chargers. That's dug out nicely by the Chemics. Dow will look to respond. It's Atten at the net, sending it out of bounds, and a point for Midland High. 19-9, Midland with complete control can really take a stranglehold of this game. As Wolf serves for the Chemics. Wolf sets to Jensen, tip in for the point for Midland High. And that's exactly how you draw it up, huh, Sydney?
Yeah, quite a few tips within this game, and I think Dow might have to look at being more aggressive on defense in order to pick those up. But then again, so does Midland, because quite a few tips has dropped on their side.
That one sent long. And Dow will take over, trailing by 10 as Midland High has doubled up their score, 20-10. And for Midland High, checking into the game will be Marie Plaver to replace Grace Reckaway. Atten serves for the Chargers, looking to get them back into this game. And then an effective hit by the Chemists. It's McMath with the kill, and Midland on top 21-10.
Great swing there from McMath, very aggressive.
Jennifer Grinwis will check in for the Chemics as Jensen will serve for Midland High. Miscommunication by the Chargers, and that's something, the kind of mistake you touched on in the pregame. You can't have that in a game of this magnitude.
Yeah, it's tough when you get down by 12 points. You get in your own head and forget to communicate, so that's something that the Chargers are going to have to fix.
That's a great point. You start to play outside your means. And there's another example of it as Midland High again gets the point. This time serving for the Chemics was Paige Murphy. And that one was too tough to handle for the Chargers. And it's a 23-10 advantage for Midland High in the opening set. Another serve by Murphy. And again, it's another ace as Dow looks a little bit frustrated, and rightfully so, as Midland High has taken complete control of this one and are on the verge of winning this first set. It's set point 24-10. Murphy serves, dug out by Atten, set by Skinner. And that one swung too long, and Midland High will take the first game decisively, 25-10.
Again, a little bit of miscommunication on that last play. The setter didn't quite set where the hitter was, and I think if Dow fixes their communication, they'll do a lot better in this next set.
Now that's going to definitely have to be addressed by Coach Dietrich and the rest of the Chargers coaching staff. And if you're Coach Zerl, who should be noted, recently picked up his 600th win as a varsity volleyball coach, a very impressive feat. And the way his team's playing tonight, you can see why he's reached that win total. But chance for Dow to respond. That's the beauty of the volleyball system. It's a best 3 out of 5 scenario. Midland has taken the first game easily by a score of 25-10. And Dow will look to make the adjustments and get back in it. If you're just joining us, I'm Jake Rietma alongside Sydney Groylick of the Northwood University Timberwolves volleyball team. And Sydney, we certainly thank you for being here, offering all kinds of keen insights on this evening's match between these two bitter rivals, the Dow Chargers and Midland Chemics.
After that first match, it'll be really important for Midland to keep the pedal to the metal. It's easy to let up after winning by such a large margin, but I think if Midland keeps playing the way they are, and if the Chargers pick it up a little bit, add some communication, it'll definitely be a great night of volleyball.
While we have a little bit of time between games, we're going to pick your brain a little bit. What's it like? Take us inside the huddle, first starting with the Midland Chemics. Let's start with the Dow Chargers. If you just lost a game 25-10, what's your mindset? Do you just completely push that game aside and focus on the next, or do you try to take what went well and carry it forward?
Definitely have a talk with the team. Everyone mentioned something they want to fix the next game. I think one of the large things they would have said is communication. But again, yeah, forgetting what just happened and realizing that you are a great team and you did make some errors, but this game you have to wipe it clean or you won't play up to your level in the next one.
And that's a great point. And now quickly, before we begin this second game, if you're inside that Midland huddle, of course you've been on both ends in your collegiate career, if you just win a first set handedly, how tough is it then to go out and replicate that kind of performance?
It's definitely important not to get too excited and to stay level-headed, because you did just win by quite a lot, but the team across the net is going to be upset about that loss that just happened, so they're going to come out firing. So it's important to keep talking to each other and say the first couple points don't go well, to remember you did just win by a lot, it is possible, keep talking with each other and keep pushing.
Very well said. And again, reminder, you are watching Midland High versus Dow High in Saginaw Valley League Volleyball on MPS TV 190 on Charter or Channel 99 on AT&T UVerse in Midland. This event will be shown on Friday, October 21st at 11:30 p.m., Saturday, October 22nd at 2 p.m., and then again on Sunday, October 23rd at 10:30 p.m. So you will not want to miss any of those broadcasts as we resume play here with Midland High leading 1-0 and the Chargers serving. And Midland picks up right where they left off with a kill by Ellie Jensen to take the 1-0 lead and continue the momentum from set one into the second set.
That was a great aggressive swing from Jensen cross court there.
The Dow High student section hasn't had much to cheer about, but they are still making their presence known with the loud oohs and ahs. And now a foul against Dow will give the point to Midland High. Continuing to serve for the Chemics, Aaron Sheridan. 2-0 Midland High in the early going. Atten with a big kill for the Chargers. And if they can set that up, that's how they'll be successful. Very impressive from Nadia Atten.
That was a great swing off the block.
Skinner to serve for the Dow Chargers. But before she does, checking in to the game for Dow High is Haley Tanis. Quick turnaround by Midland High, and it's a point. What an impressive swing there by number 15, Emma Wolf, caught the Chargers off guard.
She's been very aggressive throughout this game. I believe that's her third or fourth dump, and two have come close to scoring, and that one did.
Those kind of plays always catch me off guard. That's probably why I'm not playing. And another error for the Chargers. They will give the point to Midland High. They take a 4-1 lead, and continuing to serve for the Midland High Chemics, it's Emma Wolf. Atten gets blocked at the net, but she sticks with it. And now Jensen on the other end with a kill for the Midland High Chemics. Jensen and Reckaway continuing to be that dynamic duo that has taken the Saginaw Valley League by storm and helped the Chemics remain unbeaten in conference play. Skinner with the set to work. Midland on the other side. Dow digs it out now. There's a play at the net that will go in favor of Dow High. It's Jenna Livingston knocking it down for the Chargers. And now Blazy will serve for Dow. 5-2 in the early going in the second set. Midland High leads the match 1-0. Jensen on the other end with a forceful kill. No one was digging that one.
Midland's libero has been playing really well so far. Julia Gross, she just made that pass. And like I said before, it all starts with a pass. She made a great pass, great set, great kill.
Atten's kill's dug up by Jensen. And now Reckaway on the other end gets it done. An impressive swing by Grace Reckaway, the junior. 7-2 Midland High. Again, they won the first set 25-10. If you're just joining us, Jake Rietma alongside Sydney Groylick of the Northwood University Timberwolves volleyball team. Skinner sets to Atten. She's blocked at the net by Reckaway. And then Reckaway is blocked by Atten to give the point for the Chargers. But Coach Zerl makes, obviously said the right thing, because the point goes back to Midland High. And now, while we have a minute, we'll let you take this one.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what's going on here. I knew Atten knew it wasn't their point. I'm waiting to see what the call was.
We have one official conferencing with another, but the end-all, be-all result is a point for Midland High, and that's what the scoreboard will say, 8-2. That one served into the antenna. An error by the Chemics gives the point to Dow to make it 8-3. Atten to serve for the Chargers, trying to get Dow back into this second game. Reckaway swings. It's dug out by Blazy. Now a point for Dow.
Atten's doing a great job of serving. It might not be the most aggressive serve, but I think she knows that she has to put it in and over in order for her team to play defense against it and try to score points.
And Isabel Velasquez did a nice job of finishing that point for the Chargers, who now trail 8-4. Make that 9-4 as Midland High picks up the point. And serving now for Midland High will be Julia Gross, who you mentioned has had a great game, kind of the quiet, effective player that she is, in setting up both Reckaway and Jensen for the Midland Chemics. Skinner kept that alive, but too tall as it's up into the rafters of the gymnasium, giving the point to the Midland Chemics, making it 10-4. And Dow needs to regroup. Gross continues to serve for Midland High. That one's dug out nicely by the Chargers. Blasey to Atten. And Atten places it perfectly for the Chargers. Query will check back in for the Chargers to do the serving, looking to get them back into this game as Midland has the 10-5 lead. Midland narrowly kept that alive, but Dow is able to obtain the point.
Again, that all started with a great pass from Query, which is nice to see. A great pass, great set, great hit, and Midland could just not pick it up.
So often in those scramble situations, anything can happen, but Dow will certainly take the point. Back-to-back points for the Chargers. It's now 10-8. 10-7, rather, as Query will continue to serve for Dow. Query putting together a little bit of a hot streak here for the Chargers, getting them back in it. And right on cue, she sends it a little bit long. I'll take partial responsibility for that.
Yeah, spoke a little too soon on that one.
I certainly did, and that is the cardinal sin. But nonetheless, Dow right back in this game, 11-8, as Midland High serves. Atten from the back row. Dug out by McMath, or Sheridan rather, and Midland comes away, or rather Dow comes away with the point. And now serving for the Chargers, Madison Soule.
You can see Midland's communication breaking down a little bit. Hopefully that picks up.
It's 11-10. Midland led by a score of 10-4 at one point, so the Chargers have regained some control to make this a close game as Reckaway sends it a bit too long. And now the Dow student section starting to pick up the intensity of their cheering as they sense a little bit of a Charger comeback here, all tied up at 11. Soule continues to serve for Dow. Skinner sets up Velasquez, but it's blocked nicely by Midland High. She gets another chance and buries it that time.
Great tool off the block there for the Chargers. Sometimes on those tough sets, it's just as easy to tool off the block as it is to put it in the court. Again, an aggressive dump there by Wolf. That's what her fourth of the match. She scores on 2 out of 4 of them, so.
Yeah, that's starting to become her signature move in this match, but this is a lot of what we expected, a back and forth match with both crowds into it in this electric atmosphere as Midland takes the point and Reckaway will continue to serve, but a close game like this will certainly have the crowd into it here in the second set. 13-12 in favor of Midland High. Jensen with a huge kill for the Chemics, and that was set up beautifully, and she does not miss from there.
Yeah, that was a beautiful set by Emma Wolf.
When she's set up like that, there's not a lot Dow can, or any team for that matter, can do. And the point goes to Midland. And now Midland jumping ahead as Dow tied it at 12. But three straight points by the Chemics with Reckaway serving makes it 15-12. an unforced error on the Chemics. Give Dow a much needed point. And now Velasquez will look to get the Chargers back in line. Great volley here by both teams. And it's going to end with the Dow high point. That was a long volley where neither team could really get what they wanted to set up, but Dow will certainly take the point. 15-14 now.
Again, a great pass, a great set, a great hit. There's not much you can do once you get a good pass like that. I almost tell myself it's over when I see a pass that nice.
Wolf to Jensen has been a lethal combination for Midland High thus far. Out of bounds, right idea by the Chargers, but not executed correctly. And Midland jumps ahead 17-14 in this second set.
Ooh, just out there by Atten. That was a great swing. It's probably a foot out.
A very close call, but definitely the right call. And Midland now on top 18-14. Wolf set to Jensen. That was one of the few times it didn't work out for the Chemics as she hits it into the net and Dow takes the point. And checking back in for the Chargers will be Haley Tanis, and Jillian Skinner will serve for Dow. 18-15 in favor of Midland High.
Great back set there from Wolf. Again, she's definitely distributes the ball well.
She does indeed, and with Reckaway and Jensen, that combination to distribute to, it's a very deadly combination for the Midland Chemics. 19-15, they lead. And we have a whistle to halt play, giving the point to Midland High. And now this is the danger zone if you're Dow. 20-15, you've been in this game. It was tied at 12, but Midland has jumped ahead and has a chance to close out this game. 20-15.
Tight pass there.
Tough spot for Skinner as Jensen comes away with another kill for Midland High. And now it's 21-15 in favor of the Chemics with Emma Wolf serving for Midland High. Just gets it over the net, but Dow somehow digs it out. Midland.
That's tough. Adam made a great pancake there over the net. That doesn't happen often, and would have been nice to see the Chargers pick that up, but the Midland Chemics ended up getting that point.
And a timeout taken by Dow at 22-15. So we'll stay right here. And you alluded to it a little bit. One of my favorite plays in volleyball is that pancake save with the hands straight out. So tough to execute, I would imagine.
It is, yeah. You just have to keep your hand flat on the ground and hope the ball bounces right off of it. A lot of the times it's tough for refs to call if there's a lot of players around whether it actually went off your hand or not. So usually saying it's up or go makes, even if you're not 100% sure it even went off your hand, it usually makes the ref think it did. So.
Oh, yeah. Always got to sell it. It's part of the gamesmanship that's so important at any level. But 22-15 in favor of Midland High. We're inside the Dow High Gymnasium. Thanks for being a part of our broadcast. Jake Rietma alongside Sydney Groilich, a member of the Northwood Timberwolves volleyball team, offering us all kinds of insightful analysis throughout the course of today's match as Midland High serves and gets it just inside the line. Emma Wolf with a great ace that somehow got the yellow paint there and gave the point to Midland High. Wolf will continue to serve. A powerful shot dug out by Dow. A great effort by Dow on a couple of different plays, but to no avail as Midland gets the point.
It's great to see so much aggression from both games because I know the tension is high and it's easy to try to tip a lot of points.
There's another ace from Wolf to close it out for Midland High. They win the second set as well and take a commanding 2-0 lead in this one. This score 25-15, so a better effort from Dow, but Midland still clearly the better team as they take the 2-0 advantage and have a stranglehold on this match.
Yeah, this next game is important for sure. I mean, it's easy to be Midland and be confident, but I have been in that situation where I'm up 2 and it does end up being taken to a fifth set. So it's gonna be important for Midland to keep the pressure on and don't let the Chargers fight back. But then again, the Chargers need to step it up a little bit in this game because I think they know they're capable. They just need to add some communication and be a little bit more aggressive up at the net.
And that's a really good point. If you're Dow, you've got to start to chip away one point, one game at a time. You're not going to get it all back at once. You've got to eat the elephant one bite at a time. While we have a moment, let's remind you that the coverage of this volleyball game is being produced by MCTV volunteers and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one, come out to the next orientation training class on November 12th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. to start your training. You can learn about the upgraded high-definition ready MCTV and how to become a TV producer, as well as get hands-on training to volunteer. The cost is just $45, which includes your first-year access membership fee. If you're interested, call 837-3474 or come on down to the MCTV studio in the lower level of the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. You can learn more at www.cityofmidlandmichigan.gov/MCTV. What I took out of all that is you are watching this game in high definition, which is certainly neat. And a reminder, you can watch these broadcasts between the Dow High Chargers and the Midland High Chemics on Friday, October 21st, as well as Saturday, October 22nd, and Sunday, October 23rd. And again, Jake Rietma alongside Northwood's own Sydney Groelich. We are excited to have you for this evening's match between the Dow High Chargers and the Midland High Chemics. Midland with a commanding 2-0 lead as Reckaway will open the third set of this game. Reminder, it's 3 out of 5, meaning if Midland High is able to continue their prowess, they win and win this match, or win this set rather, they take the match. And that is a good start as Reckaway takes the ace for the Midland Chemics, and it's 1-0 in favor of the Midland Chemics. Reckaway will continue to serve for Midland High.
A good deep swing there from the Chargers.
There was that pancake play, a great effort by Gross for the Chemics, but to no avail, and Dow High takes the point off the kill by Atten.
A good tip there over the block from Atten. Putting it in the right place like that, she's been a really smart player tonight.
Skinner to serve for Dow. Jensen on the other end. Jensen with another dominating swing. And I want to touch briefly while we have a chance on that quick set you saw Dow utilize there. Could that be an adjustment in the game plan, or is that just a typical play?
I think that the quicker sets will clear up the space for the blockers, allowing more space on the court to hit. So I'll have to wait till I see it again and see.
It could be an adjustment the Chargers are trying to make to get back into this game, or into this match rather, early in this third game as they come away with the point. And checking back in for Dow will be Madison Soul. Blazy to serve for the Chargers. They trail 2-0 in sets.
Both teams have been really scrappy tonight, which we've witnessed on the defensive end, which is nice to see. I mean, definitely in a match that means this much, it's hard not to be scrappy.
That's a good point. The Saginaw Valley League title on the line. If Midland wins, they take the crown outright. If Dow wins, the two schools, Midland and Dow, that is, share the SVL title for the 2016 season. A strong hit by Midland High, and it was tipped by Dow, giving the point to the Chemics. That was Peyton Gerstacker, who's been effective all match long for the Chemics.
Great pass for the Chargers.
That one sent way long, and Dow will certainly take it, as the score now reads 4-3 in favor of the Midland Chemics, but Atten serving for the Chargers.
Tough one there. Atten just didn't get a good enough touch on that, right into the net. Couldn't be picked up, but definitely a good defensive effort on her end.
Jensen to serve for the Chemics. And Dow dodges a bullet with that service error. As Dow will make a couple of different changes here. In for the Chargers, Allison Burrell, as well as Query to serve. Query's had a very good match serving for the Chargers. She was the one that got them back in the game in the second set by giving the Chargers a couple of straight points. There's Reckaway with the strong kill, sent out of bounds, and a point for Midland High. Grace Reckaway displaying her athletic ability on that impressive kill. Another strong serve by Midland High, Julia Gross. She's had a very good game in all facets of the match for the Chemics.
She has had a good game, aggressive on defense and serving. A great pass from the Chargers, a great set, and a great kill.
Madison Soule getting into the action for the Chargers, and now she'll head to the service line with Dow trailing 7-5. This is the third set between these two teams. Midland High won the first two.
Great tool off the block there from McMath. She's a very aggressive player. Throughout the night, she has hit a couple out, but every swing is aggressive, which is nice to see.
That certainly keeps the Chargers on their toes. As that time, it goes into the net, and Dow will take the point. For Midland High, Marie Plaver will check in. That one just scrapes that corner line for a nice serve by the Chargers, as it was Isabel Velasquez painting the corner. That's got to be tough to read.
That was a great serve. I mean, honestly, in that situation, you kind of just got to clap it off, turn around, and try to pass the next one.
And that they do, as that one sails out of bounds, exactly what you alluded to, right on cue. See, you're good at calling what's about to happen. I'm good at the opposite, unfortunately. Reckaway to serve for
Midland
High.
Good aggressive serve there.
Atten at the net. And the Chargers able to dig out one from Jensen, and the point continues. Long volley. Atten with the tip. There's Jensen again. And now a back corner set. And that's how it will end, with Jensen hitting it simply where the Chargers weren't, with authority. Another kill for Ellie Jensen. 10-7 in favor of Midland High. Recaway to serve for the Chemics, as it is just in a very strong serve from Grace Recaway. Burrell looked a little crossed up on that one as it was just on the line. She didn't know whether she should let it go or let it stay. And there's another ace from Grace. Seven in favor of Midland High as Skinner will check back in for the Dow Chargers. Another effective serve by Recaway, and that will force Dow to take the timeout as they trail 13-7, and really no answer for Grace Recaway at the service line lately by the Chargers.
Yeah, Grace is on a really good serving run right now. I mean, it's smart of the Chargers to take a timeout. They're trying to ice her a little bit, so it'll be important for Grace to come out there and be confident and try to get that first serve in.
No doubt about it, and Grace Recaway, of course, gets her athleticism from her mother, clearly not her father, head coach of the Northwood basketball team, Jeff Recaway. That is for certain. 13-7 in favor of Midland High in the third game. Best 3 out of 5, Midland won the first two. Won them handedly as Dow attempts to get back into this game.
That's a tough one. Grace misses that, which happens a lot after a timeout, but.
Yeah, almost like icing a kicker in football. You take the timeout to ice the server and regroup, and that's exactly what Coach Dietrich and the Chargers did. We'll see if they can build some momentum off of it as Skinner serves for Dow. There's a nice block by the Chargers, but unfortunately it goes out of bounds. And Sydney, that's probably exactly how Dow wanted to set it up, but unfortunately just a tough bounce out of bounds.
Yeah, that was a great swing. Definitely, I mean, if the block's not pressed towards the middle, it's easy to tool off them like that, which is exactly what Jensen did.
Some miscommunication by Dow, but they're able to bounce back and keep the play alive.
Again, with the tool off the block from Jensen. That's a tough one. I mean, the block's there, but it's just not pressed properly. Good play, though, by Jensen to see that and to realize that that's an easy play to make.
Nice dig by Skinner to keep the play alive.
Again with that dump from Wolf. She's being really effective with that tonight, sneaking it in the middle of plays, middle of rallies. That's definitely something that the Chargers need to watch for, is when she's up there to set, to be aware that she is aggressive and she will put that second ball over.
Yeah, it catches me off guard every time. Gerstacker's shot is dug up by the Chargers. And that swing sent out of bounds by Tanis just a bit too far. And she had the right idea, as that area of the court was open, but unfortunately sent it out of bounds, and Midland High will take the point. As checking in for the Midland High Chemics for to serve will be Emma Jamrog.
A good aggressive serve there. The Chargers got behind it, just couldn't get the right angle on it.
And checking in for the Dow High Chargers will be Shayna Draves.
Good pass there. And a good tip by Atten. She's been really effective with those tips tonight, seeing where they need to be, brushing them off the block. Definitely using her smarts in tonight's game.
Certainly a versatile player that brings a lot to the table for Coach Dietrich's Chargers as Blazy serves for Dow. Anna Blazy with the effective serve makes it 18-10 in favor of Midland High.
Again, with the tool off the block for Midland, great set by Wolf. They're really using that, they're really tooling the block well tonight, actually.
Serving for Midland High will be Emma Wolf. Isabel Velasquez back in for the Chargers as Atten serves.
Smart play there by Gerstacker, high up at the net. Not needing to be aggressive, but putting the ball in a place that no one will be. It's a good play.
Now, when you're in that position, you see that ball fluttering right there for the taking. Your eyes have definitely got to light up.
Yeah, I mean, there's times where you could hit it as hard as you can, or you can place it smart like she did.
Another point for the Chemics as they take a commanding 21-11 lead in this third game. Again, best 3 out of 5, and Midland High won the first 2 games. So a chance for Midland High to complete the clean sweep with a couple more points. Dow will look to rebound, though. We have a whistle that halts play and gives the point to the Dow High Chargers. Let's see if they can build some momentum off of it. Checking in for Midland High, Haley Worth. And in for the Dow Chargers will be number 3, Allison Burrell.
Great aggressive swing there from Rekaway. Just like you said, she put it right in the middle of the court where no one was, and that's been a really effective shot for her tonight.
It's 22-12 in favor of the Midland High Chemics. They've been the better team all match long. Gerstacker to serve. Dow looking to get back into this game and match particularly.
Good defensive effort there by Atten, but just not enough to bring the ball back over the net to the Chemics, and Midland scores the point.
Now the student section's beginning to chant back and forth, something that adds another element to this great rivalry. Midland High and Dow High will face off in just about every single fall sport at some point. The big football game will be Friday night. Midland High has been the better team this afternoon, or this evening rather. 23-13, Dow with the service. Midland High looking to close out. And a point for the Chemics at the net. Standing guard was Jennifer Grinwis for the Chemics. And she'll head to the service line looking to close this one out. 24-13 in favor of Midland High. It's set point. Burrell with a nice kill for the Chargers. 24-14. A nice crowd on hand tonight at the Dow High Gymnasium. Still set point, match point rather, as Midland High can take the match, leading 24-14. And that's how this one will end. A fitting exclamation point. It's Wolf delivering the shot and the kill for the Chemics to send the Chargers home and give the Midland High Chemics the victory here tonight. Sydney, they were the better team all match long. 25-14, the final in this one. And Midland High will celebrate as Saginaw Valley League champions.
They played a great game tonight, communicated well, played some really great clean volleyball. It was really nice to see.
Midland High takes all three games over the Dow High Chargers. This one by a score of 25-14. And with the win, Midland High moves to 8-0 in the Saginaw Valley League and 25-17 overall. With the loss, Dow falls to 23-8 overall, but 6-2 in the Saginaw Valley League. And as we take a quick look back, Sydney, just Midland was the better team that executed throughout the course of this entire match, a big reason why they're moving on as Saginaw Valley League champions. And with that said, we thank you all for being a part of this evening's broadcast. The coverage of this volleyball game was being produced by MCTV, volunteers, and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one, come to the next orientation studio training class on November 12th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. to start your training. The cost is $45, which includes your first year access membership fee. Call 837-3474 or visit www.cityofmidlandmi.gov/MCTV. And don't forget, these games will be available on Friday, October 21st at 11:30 p.m., Saturday, October 22nd at 2 p.m., and Sunday, October 23rd at 10:30 p.m. For my broadcast partner, Northwood's own Sydney Groelich, I'm Jake Rietma, thanking you for being a part of this evening's broadcast. We look forward to the next time we have the chance to bring you all the action in the Midland area. But until then, we wish you all the best and say good night. And until next time.